Hey, today I want to talk to you about Lens. Lens is a Kubernetes IDE that runs on your desktop. It's created by Mirantis, and you might have seen me use it in previous videos that I've done around anything cloud native, Kubernetes related. There are three pricing tiers. Personal use, $0. You get to use it for free. Fantastic. There's also a pro and enterprise version, and if you are using it at a company that makes more than $10 million in annual revenue, you are required by license to use either the pro or enterprise version. So I don't get to use this during my workday. I just use the personal version for messing around with CNCF projects, learning new skills, experimenting, breaking clusters, all the fun things that I get to do. Right? At work, I have to use Kubernetes Dashboard. Now, Kubernetes Dashboard has gotten me pretty far. I don't want to knock it, but I will say Lens, in my personal time, is a lot more fun to use. And let's dive into all the reasons why. Now, if you want to, you can always check out the documentation, but today I'm going to show you some of my favorite features and how you can use them for experimenting in Kubernetes like I do. So the first major benefit of using Lens over Kubernetes Dashboard is visible already. We don't have to install things in our Kubernetes clusters. We can use Lens based on our local Kubeconfigs. It uses your Kubeconfigs on your local machine to connect to these clusters. So not only do we not have to install something in our clusters, but we can also connect to more than one cluster at once. I'm connected to three clusters right now. I've got a kind cluster, a management cluster in EKS, and this EKS cluster that I just set up this morning. So let's dive in and take a look at what's going on in some of these. Here's my management cluster in EKS. So you can see I've got all of the resources that I have in my Kubernetes cluster. I can view those the same way I would in Kubernetes Dashboard. If I want to view my pods, I click on pods, they load up, and here I am. All namespaces, I can see all my pods. I can click into a pod, right? This one's part of a stateful set. And if I want to see the logs, I can. Look, I've got all of the containers in this pod. I can activate them and pull all of the logs for each container in the pod. You can't do that in Kubernetes Dashboard. You can only do one container at a time. So that's a huge benefit right there. But if I also wanted to, I could look at a deployment, right? And just like you could in Kubernetes Dashboard, let's say I want to change this Argo CD deployment. I can update the YAML in line right here, hit this save button, and update my deployment, right? I can also search in the YAML. I can search for something like, I don't know, service. There it is, right? And I can see all the different places where the word service is used. Cool, so it's got built-in searching, it's got built-in editing. What else does it have? Well, if I wanna come down to my custom resources, right? Kubernetes Dashboard groups custom resources under the same tab. Well, Lens expands on that. Lens allows me to see all of the different pluggable APIs that have been added to my cluster. So here they all are. They're all listed out, right? And if I want to click on, for example, libprojects-svelte.io, here are all of the custom resource definitions that have been created in this cluster. And I can click on any one of them, and I can see the resources listed individually. Plus, let's say I want to edit them. I can do that, right? I can see the labels that have been added to them, which if you've watched my Svelte videos, you'll know labels are kind of a big deal in Svelte. But I can also edit the YAMLs for these as well. How awesome is that? So let's get out of here. I want to come into this fresh EKS cluster that I have, that I stood up this morning. All right, let me drill into this. And I want to click on this Helm tab down here. We click on this, it's going to show me any releases that I've got installed in this cluster. And as I said, I just did this EKS cluster up this morning, so there are no releases. If we wanted to come back to my management cluster in EKS, and we click on Helm releases from here, we'll see I've got a bunch of stuff that I've installed, including Project Svelte. It's cool. So you can see the releases that have been installed, and we can even see here are the values that were added into this release. And here are the ones that I supplied, meaning these are the only ones that don't match the default. So you can look, you can filter to see what values were applied to each Helm release right in this IDE. That's freaking nuts. So let's get out of here. Come back up to this EKS cluster I created this morning. We'll dive into that. We'll come to Helm and we're gonna click on this charts option right here. This is where it gets really cool. So it's loading. It does take a second because it's got a lot to load, and we're gonna see why in just a second. Here they are. All of the charts that Lens has registered that you can pull down and install directly in your cluster, like right now. So I'm gonna do this, watch. I'm gonna install Argo CD just by clicking, right? I clicked on Argo CD. I'm gonna click install. It's going to give me a Helm values file, right? A values YAML right here. And I can edit this, and I'm going to. So let me find password. Okay, I'm gonna search for password. You can see I've got my search down here. So I want to update the Argo server admin password. So I'm going to write this, that. That will be my admin password. We're gonna deploy this and we're gonna prove it. All right, so there it is. I'm gonna click this save button now. This is going to Helm install Argo with these values. So I click save. And this is my favorite thing about Lens, because you can experiment. You can go nuts experimenting with all the different things that you want to try out just by clicking around in this Kubernetes IDE. So it's, there it is, Helm release, Argo CD, etc. installed, right? It's installed successfully. I click on releases, we can kill that. Here it is. This is my Argo CD installation. So let's close out of here. And we'll close out of here. And the first thing I want to do, I want to look at my pods. Argo CD should be stood up. It's standing up. It's in the process. Cool. So now I want to come down to config, secrets, and Argo CD secret. This is where the admin password is stored. So if I click on this and I come down to clear password, that's my password that I entered. So Argo CD was installed with all of the values that I asked for, right? So now we have a password that I explicitly set in my values YAML. So that was pretty cool. Let's see if it actually worked. So I'm gonna come up to my pods, and sure enough, Argo is progressing, right? So it's getting there. Let me look at my services. I'll close this down. Network, service. All right. One of the coolest features. I can click on Argo CD server, right? This is where I'm going to connect to. This is my service that I'm connecting to. I can port forward from this Kubernetes IDE. I can click on any one of these ports and forward it so that I can connect using my local host and in a local port connecting to this service running in EKS. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to click on this. And when I do, right, it's going to list these options, HTTPS, open in browser. This open in browser, this is going to happen really fast, right? I've got Chrome right behind this Lens window. So I'm going to click start, and it's going to assign a random local port to map to this service running in EKS. I click start, and here we go. Localhost 49460. I got a privacy error because the cert isn't properly set up. That's fine. I'm aware of that. Advanced. Proceed to localhost. It's unsafe. Yes, it is. Here's Argo. So it's already connecting. Now I can click in admin and this, that, and sign in. All set up exactly as I expected it would, right? Using the Kubernetes IDE Lens. Again, I can go from cluster to cluster. I can compare YAMLs. I can edit YAMLs. I can edit labels. I can do anything that I would normally do with command line. I can do anything I would do in Kubernetes dashboard right in the Lens IDE. To me, this thing is invaluable. I love using it for experimenting, as you can see, especially with Helm. So if you found this video useful, please drop a like. If you want to see more cloud native stuff, I got a lot more coming. Please consider subscribing. And if there's stuff that you want to see, I am taking suggestions. Drop a comment and let me know. Thanks for watching.